Hey, church family, I'm excited to bring you a message today. During these uncertain times, we keep calling it an unprecedented, unparalleled, perilous, chaotic time that we're living in. We're all stuck at home. So we hope to bring you a little bit of hope every Wednesday. And in case you missed it, you can check it out, I believe, on our website or on YouTube, Oak Bend Church. And check out Pastor Daniel's message from this past Sunday about kind of how to handle these uncertain times. I want to bring you a quick word from Mark chapter 4. I want to look at it in a little bit of a different light than what you would probably normally see. Normally, I would take you through Mark chapter 4 and talk about the wind and the waves that Jesus calms, share with you three quick universal truths from God's word, and have you go live that out, right, and apply it to the storms of your life. I want to look at it from a little bit of a different perspective, and then I'll give you some closing thoughts. That this was really cool. Mark chapter 4, verse 37, a furious squall comes up. Jesus is with some of his closest people, and the storm comes out of nowhere, and it's very, very violent. The men are afraid, and if you watch Daniel's message, you'll see that that's okay. That is a human characteristic or quality that we have because of the fallenness of the world that we live in. It doesn't mean that you are a second-rate Christian if you have some fear from time to time. We're not called to live and be enveloped by fear and do everything out of fear, but check it out. He says, quiet, be still. He commands the wind and the waves to literally stop. Everything dies down, and he says to his disciples, why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith? And it says they were terrified, wondering, who is this man? I heard a story about a pastor who took in some Laotian refugees. Well, if you know anything about Laos, I have some friends who are over there as missionaries. They consider it a godless country. In fact, Christianity is kind of enemy number one of the state. Very little gospel influence. Not many people know or have heard of Jesus or have seen any of the scriptures. So this American pastor has these Laotian refugees, and they decide to be in a small group and to learn more about this man who they do not know named Jesus. Well, they came upon this story, and the pastor reads through it, and it's really interesting. I want to pull up the quote here real quick. One of the refugees says, do you mean Jesus actually calmed the wind and the sea in the middle of the storm? Now, the pastor was kind of taken off thinking, well, they just don't understand miracles. And he basically told them, we don't want to get just caught up in this whole miracle thing. We want to make sure that we know that Jesus can calm the wind and the waves of our current life, of the storms of our life. And that's true. He can. I'm not saying he can't. But the next person chimes in, still a little puzzled and confused, but they say, well, if Jesus calmed the wind and the waves, he must be a pretty powerful man. And that's the point I want to give you today. Jesus is powerful. We can't lose the awe of what he's done for us and what he can do in this world today, even during perilous times. It was so awesome. I was talking with my son Malachi this morning. He's 4. He doesn't get this whole lockdown thing, but he's having a very fun time at our house every single day, trying to explain a little bit to him. And he's asking some really good questions about the virus and who can defeat it and who can't. We're talking about people's immune systems. I'm sorry about that. And in the end of it, he says, you know what, Dad, out of everything we just said, you know that Jesus is powerful enough to defeat this virus. Man, what great truth from a 4-year-old. Jesus is on the throne. He is not going anywhere. The promises of his scripture are true. We can be in awe of Jesus as we serve him in our life right now, in the middle of the chaos and the storm that's going on. As he becomes the consuming focus of our life, we will worship him. We can be completely enamored by him. We can start afresh and anew in our relationship with him. We can be totally and completely ruined for Jesus. This can be a defining moment in our Christian walk, and our personal relationship with the Lord and the person of the Holy Spirit who he has sent to be with us. The thing I love about these Laotian believers is they didn't know the Jesus of the Gospels very well. They had just heard of him, but they worshiped him. They were all in. And what would it look like if we went all in as believers during this time? How would that change our family, our friends, and our community? How would it change our church if we had proper perspective? I want to leave you with this thought about perspective during perilous times. Vice Admiral Stockdale was one of the the most highly regarded man to ever be shot down out of a plane in the American military and taken captive during the Vietnam War. He spent time at the Hanoi Hilton. It wasn't a Hilton hotel. It was a place of torture and chaos, loneliness, desperation, and isolation. He was held in captivity for nearly 7 years. But when he was finally released, he had a brilliant career and an amazing life born out of this story of captivity. Now, it wasn't true for all the men that he was there at the hotel with. Many men didn't make it. They gave up. They lost hope. They thought, you know, by Easter, this will pass and I'll be released. And then Easter came and they were still in captivity. But by Christmas, this will surely pass. And this went on month after month and year after year. And many of these men who were held captive during the Vietnam War ultimately lost hope. But what about Mr. Stockdale? I want to read you this quote. How did he survive? He says, "I never lost faith in the end of the story. I never doubted not only that I would get out, but also that I would prevail in the end and turn the experience into the defining event of my life, which in retrospect, I would not trade." And my friends, if that's our perspective, if we embrace our current harsh, brutal, stinky reality that we have right now, yet we have hope and faith in a powerful, unimaginably powerful God. We might not know the day of when this is all going to end. The end may not be nearly in sight. We might not see the light at the end of the tunnel for quite a while, but with patient endurance, we can have hope that we serve a very powerful and a very faithful God, where I will embrace the reality of my situation right now. I will go all in for Jesus, give everything I have to him, and let him work and live in and through me and grow me substantially during this time. This can be one of the defining moments of our church and of our personal lives as we come out of this season ready and on fire to serve the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I hope this was an encouragement to you today to hang tight and know the end will come. Even though we don't know when that will happen, God is still on the throne. He is powerful above everything else. Thank you, and God bless.